Well, I have yet to look in the budget this year about the 4-piece kung magkano talaga, because I get some information sa mga tao ko na nasa 160. The bulk at the budget of DSWD came from is centered on the 4-piece. Yan yung pinakamalaki niya, 4-piece na sa over 100 million billion.
Billion. Yeah.
Ang budget kasi namin this year is like 205 billion, and of 60% of that ay doon nakasentro sa 4-piece, Ms. Karen.
Oo. Secretary, is it true that there's a lack of funds right now that's actually hampering the release for the May and June period of the 4-piece?
Wala pa naman actually, kasi thing is, bago kami lahat, Ms. Karen, eh. So I understand, I can understand that the situation, lalo na sa DM, Secretary Pangandaman has to collate everything and review everything, yung mga dahil pinasa lang. Kagaya din ko, Ms. Karen, I have to make sure na everything is in order, yung mga budget. So it will take time, siguro it will take me about 2 to 3 months to review all the expenses. Uh-oh. How much do I have? I'm not even done yet checking how many we have here in this my department, how many yung kulang na mga warehouses. So I really have to really look into this. Ganun din ang naririnig ko sa other agencies na at this very point, lahat kami medyo kailangan pa naming reviewin yung mga naiwan at saka magkano gastusin, lalo na in Department of Budget and Management, Ms. Karen.
Okay. I'm curious, you have been going around, I've read, the different offices of the DSWD. What have you discovered?
Yun, yung, like what I said, we lack transportation. Yung mga wing bags, nag-deliver ng mga food packs sa mga regions, we lack that. Meron kami mga maliliit na truck. We lack warehouses sa mga areas na kailangan.
Even yung pre-positioned warehouses, kulang pa rin.
You saw that what happened in Ifugao. Yeah. Naging controversial yung isang NGO. Dahil lagay ng LGU yung pre-positioned food packs namin na DSWD. Yeah. Tapos isang warehouse, nilagay niya rin yung mga dumarating na contribution o donation ng NGO. So pinagsama-sama. Wala kasi siyang warehouse. Oh.
Pero bawal ba yun, Secretary, under the law? Like for example, to you, for the DSWD to share a warehouse with an NGO, what if it's a reputable NGO, a known NGO, bawal po ba yun?
I have to look into that, Ms. Karen, and I have to check with my regional directors. That I haven't checked yet. Pero ang pagkaalam ko, I was briefed na bawal yung NGO i-distribute yung goods ng DSWD.
That yung, one is clear. True.
Of course, from the government, dapat diretso sa tao through the local government units. I still have to check on that. That's a very good question kung bawal sila sa isang bodega. Pero dapat, kung walang bodega, ang explanation kasi ni Mayor, wala siyang bodega. Ang sinasabi naman ng regional director ko, sana Mayor, hiniwalay mo muna. Ito yung DSWD, ito sa kanan yung mga NGO, parang ganon, Ms. Karen.
Oo. Okay, so that's one. You've discovered kulang ka ng transportation, kulang kayo ng warehouses. What about the employees? Have you discovered also, I mean, you did call the DSWD as family. Sinabi mo yun in an interview that you consider them as family. And yet you've relieved 2 DSWD employees immediately. You've only been in office for, let's say, I would say a few weeks. You've acted on them right away. Have you discovered something in terms of perhaps the motivation, the attitude? I'm curious, what have you found?
Common kasi, Ms. Karen, in a government agency na hindi naman lahat ng employees namin, pero karamihan are professionals. They come in at 8 o'clock, they work until 4 o'clock. Unfortunately, may iilan na they would just come in 8 to 4, they punch in, and then hantayin na lang yung punch out ng 4 o'clock. And then meron sinasabi because of stress daw na dealing with these people, with the elderly, with the poor. Nakukulitan na, so medyo hindi na maganda yung kanilang pakikitungo or attitude towards
parang burnout. Burnout.
That's their excuse eh. Doon sa two employees, yung sa naiyan na nirelieve ko, was saying she's been there since 2020. Ang sagot ko naman sa kanya, hindi ba umuwi ka naman sa bahay mo? Hindi ka naman dyan 24/7 sa naiya. So you go home too with your family. Yung sa Tagbilara naman ay a relief. Very unfortunate, she's in our complaint section sa grievance. Tumatanggap na reklamo tapos ganun yung attitude niya. So I have to remove her there immediately, reprimanded her and warned her, and probably she will have to undergo retraining, Miss Karen. Yung may mga kasamahan kami dito, hindi naman lahat, na medyo naging lax siguro this past few months or few years. Pati isama ko na dyan, Miss Karen, yung limang hotline operators namin. Tinestingan ko lang. Sabi ko, baka may sasagot. Wala namang sumagot. Kaya I warned them and they were saying nasa training daw sila ng mga programs.
Oo. So that's quite interesting that you did it yourself. You actually tested the services of the SWD, which is good. But what will you do now as the manager, the leader? How do you instill new energy into the department or for some of the employees? Anong plano mo, Secretary?
I have to talk to the managers, the middle managers right now within the next few weeks. Kasi what I'm doing right now is to make sure na we have enough food packs for calamities. Kasi we are typhoon now. I'm still checking yung mga warehouses namin and yung logistics namin. Step siguro, I will be talking to the regional director, to the managers. Can you see me? Can you hear me?
I can. You're good. I can see you.
To inform them, there is a new manager, SW. Okay, this is what we do. Okay, our job is to serve these people. Our clients are the poor people, hindi yung mga negosyante, hindi. And then we are not revenue generating agency. We are that spend the money of the taxpayers. Kaya I have to remind my employees na ginagastos natin yung binabayad na buwis ng taong bayan. And gastusin natin sa tabang pamara. Second, ang clients natin are not the taxpayers. Ang clients natin, yung mga end user ng taxes. But still, we have to treat them right, okay? Because that is the mandate, social welfare. Helping the poor and the needy, the elderly, etc. Hindi mo pwede to sin. Because kung wala ito, Ms. Karen, they're not there. I keep on reminding them every week that because of these people, DSW exists. Otherwise, then wala na kaming trabaho pag wala na matatanda sa amin. Ito na nga, I reminded them because of this Mandanas law. Maraming programs kami na mawawala. For example, assistance for individual in crisis. Yung mga medical, yung mga burial. It will be devolved to the LGUs. So, mga pupunta na doon, di ba? So, mawawala na kami ng tao. Eh, pag nawala na ng tao, ano pang gagawin ng mga tao doon sa who runs that AIX program or that crisis intervention program. So that's what I keep on reminding them. Na umayos tayo because our job is to help these people.
Are you seeing, Secretary, that eventually you will be, right now you are in a way streamlining parts of the DSWD, but do you see that you'll be streamlining the organization itself? Will some people lose their jobs at one point?
No, I promised Ms. Karen, these people, my staff, everybody, that the 29,000, especially the 11,000 contract of service. Now they will have jobs until 2028, till as long as I'm here, provided that they do their job. Yung sila yung mga bastos, di ba? They do their job, treat the clients well, then they're okay. Pero I understand. And also what you mean streamlining because nga dun sa we have a problem with the budget.
Yeah.
The president was asked during our first cabinet meeting on that. Oh. And clearly he said like, wag naman tayo magtanggal ng tao kasi kasama yan sa pandemic recovery. Pag nagtanggal ka ng tao, paano siya makarecover? My point to yung Pangulong Marcos. So as much as possible, iiwasan yung mga pagtanggal-tanggal ng mga tao because everybody has to recover from the pandemic. He said was like, maghanap na lang kayo ng other means na para to cut cost to save budget, to save money. So look in other direction, not doon sa pagtatanggal ng tao.
Okay. Now, speaking of saving money, you already have number one, the bulk is the 4Ps. You're streamlining that. But then you also said na tuloy ang ayuda. So the targeted cash transfer or the TCT program, tama ba ito, Secretary? Kasi people might mistake it na yun din ang 4Ps. This is a cash grant of 3,000 300 to 500 per month, rather, for 6 months targeted to families. Tama ba ito? Let's talk about that specifically because it said that as of July 4, 5.8 million beneficiaries have received their subsidy. Ano to exactly and how long will this stay?
500 pesos per household yan, Ms. Karen, for 12 million ang estimate yan household who will benefit in that program. We have already distributed katatlong tranches po yan. Actually, supposedly, 6 tranches, dahil 6 months, di ba? E para malaki-laki, so ginawa na, pinagsama na namin yung first tranche ng 2 months. I think that's April or May to June. So binigay na namin yan. Yung sunod nila is June to July, and then all September. Yan yung promise ng past administration to ease up yung burden ng mga mahihirap because of the rising cost of fuel and yung commodities. Unfortunately, we still have to scrounge for the next round, yung second. We have for that. And then yung third tranche, we really have to look for that.
Okay. When you say you have to scrounge and look for the next tranche, how much do you need to look for exactly?
Kasi yung itong nilabas ng DBM is about 6 billion eh. So I still need like around 12 billion or plus to be able to sustain that hanggang dun sa third tranche. 6 to 10 billion yung every tranche. As a matter of fact, kulang nga yung 6 billion na yun eh.
And are these families, Secretary, different from the beneficiaries of 4Ps?
Yun na sila yung pinakauna, Ms. Karen. That's what the former administration said, na unahin. So sinundan lang na DSWD, yung 4Ps, yung mga social pensioner, sila yung uunahin.
Oo. So it's the same people essentially.
Exactly. Parang ganun. So and then pag savings, that's why I today will be asking my finance department to look into this. Paano nga naman yung iba na hindi kasama sa 4Ps.
Secretary, is there an innovative way, considering there's an issue of funds, is there an innovative way that's allowed by law for you to source in kind, you know, what's needed from the private sector? Are you allowed under the law? For example, let's say bigas, supplier talaga, or let's say gatas, talagang from a company. How flexible are you when it comes to that? So hindi lang pera ang kailangan yung ibigay. Let's say a private company handling the beneficiaries in a certain area. I mean, it's a bit more creative, but I don't know how flexible you are in terms of what's legal.
I think it's legal naman, Ms. Karen, during calamities, during disasters, if you remember, during that anda, the DSWD was accepting donations from the private sector, and then it is handed, we repack it, and then we hand it down to the LGUs para sila na mag-distribute. Yes, I think hindi against the law yon during calamities, Ms. Karen.
Okay. All right. We are going to take a quick break, Secretary Tulfo. When we return, we'll...